Property Investment for Beginners by Rob Dix. Rob Dix is one of the two Robs who presents one of the UK's most popular business podcasts, The Property Podcast, and has written a number of the UK's most popular property investment books. In the financial independence community, most people are comfortable with investing in shares, but outside the FIRE movement, there are many people who love the thought of getting involved in property, even though they wouldn't dream of investing in the stock market. So why is property such a popular investment option? Rob says it comes down to the following three reasons. Number one, property is tangible. You can see it, touch it, and everyone needs to live in one, and people intuitively understand the process of renting out a property. Number two, property offers unusually high potential returns because of leverage. Banks will lend you majority of the money to invest in property, not something they are prepared to do against most other asset classes. And number three, property has some level of intrinsic value and people feel confident that this will continue into the future. Basic property investment principles, loan to value, LTV. The LTV is the loan as a proportion of the value of the property expressed as a percentage. For example, if you're buying a £200,000 property with a £50,000 deposit, you'll need a 75% loan to value mortgage based on a 25% deposit. Equity, best thought of as the amount of money that you would have left if you sold a property and paid off the loans against it. Leverage, this term is mentioned a lot in property because this is one of the fundamental advantages of investing in property. Here's an example of how using leverage can amplify your investment. Investor A has 100k cash and buys a house outright. 10 years later, the house has doubled and they sell it for 200k. That's 100% return on investment. Investor B, on the other hand, has 25k and takes out a mortgage of 75k to buy a house of 100k. 10 years later, they sell it for the same £200,000, and after paying back the mortgage, they are left with the original 25k deposit plus 100k profit. That's a 400% return on investment. However, be warned, leverage also comes with a large amount of risk because if the price of the asset drops, the losses are also magnified. So always approach leverage with caution. There is no free lunch in investing. Essential property calculations. A lot of people buy properties without a clue of how to analyse the potential investment and how it compares to other investment opportunities. These three simple calculations are a good place to start. Gross yield. Gross yield is the annual income generated by an asset divided by its price. For example, a property generates an annual rent of 12k with a purchase price of 200k. Therefore, 12k divided by 200k equals a gross yield of 6%. This gives a high level, easy way to quickly compare against other types of similar properties in the market. Net yield. Net yield is the annual profit, income minus costs, generated by an asset divided by its price. So taking the previous example further, annual rent of 12k, annual costs of 3k, including all costs such as managing agent fees, insurances, an allowance for repairs, an allowance for void periods or where the property is empty, in between tenancies, and service charges and ground rents, etc. An interest-only buy-to-let mortgage was also used, so there is a mortgage cost of £4,000. So that's total annual costs of £7,000, leaving an annual profit of 5k. Therefore, 5k divided by the 200k purchase price gives a net yield of 2.5%. Return on investment, ROI. Also known as return on cash employed. The ROI is the annual profit, income minus costs, generated by an asset, divided by the cash you've put in. If you bought a property without using leverage, then the ROI and the net yield would be the same as there are no mortgages involved and you put in the full purchase price. However, if you used a mortgage, the ROI will look different. So back to our example, annual rent of 12k, annual costs of 7k, leaving an annual profit of 5k. Purchase price of 200k on a 75% loan to value mortgage means a mortgage used of 150k and a cash deposit of 50k. Therefore, the annual profit of 5k divided by the cash invested of 50k gives an ROI of 10%. So which calculation is best to use? For me, it's the ROI, as it shows exactly what return you are getting on your cash and can be used to compare against other non-property investments. If you put that 50k in the example in the stock market via a global tracker fund, you might expect a total return somewhere in the same region of, say, 10%. However, the ROI of 10% for the property is based on income alone and ignores capital growth. But even with modest capital growth, it's not hard to see how property can easily outperform the broad stock market. But with extra return comes extra risk, effort, and hassle. Mortgages, interest only versus capital repayment. Most people that own a primary residence will be on a repayment mortgage, meaning that at the end of their loan term, they will have repaid the loan in full and own their home clear and free. However, for investment purposes, it depends on your strategy and long-term goals as to whether you choose a repayment mortgage or an interest-only mortgage. Generally speaking, buy-to-let mortgages are usually interest-only mortgages, and this allows for greater cash flow, and in many cases, after all the expenses and insurances attached with owning a rental property are taken into account, it's the only viable option, as on a repayment mortgage, the property would probably end up making a loss each month. Even though you aren't repaying the loan on an interest-only mortgage, the equity in the property will generally increase due to inflation. Plus, you always have the option to overpay on the mortgage if you want to. Over time, inflation will erode the real value of the money you owe. For example, let's say that in 2005, you borrowed 75k to buy a house worth 100k. By 2015, if the property had increased in value just in line with inflation, it would be worth 136k, but you still only owe 75k. Therefore, even without any capital repayments, the loan-to-value ratio has gone from 75% to 55%. For this reason, many investors will not worry about the debt and continue to put capital into new investments and let inflation do the work for them. Having a strategy to pay down the debt at some point as part of their exit strategy many years into the future. All these choices depend on your strategy though, and that's why it's important to educate yourself and set a suitable strategy before you get started in property. Property seems to be one of the worst industries for getting started, and it's full of people selling get-rich-quick strategies or courses to invest in property with no money down. But don't believe the hype. After all, it's called property investment for a reason. And that's because you need a decent amount of capital to invest. But with disciplined saving and shrewd investment decisions, property investing can be one of the quickest ways to get to FIRE.